So let's take a look at an app that comes with your Mac called Activity Monitor. A lot of people have asked me exactly what is this for, how do I use it. To find it, you can look in your Applications Utilities folder, or I just use Spotlight and just search for Activity Monitor, it comes up, and then I can run it that way. And this is what you see typically when you first run it. You can alter how this view looks, so it may not look this way for you if you've changed it, but you basically get this long list of processes, and you can see how much CPU they're using and other information about them. And unless you're a software engineer, you're probably not going to know what most of this is. But that's okay, because you can ignore most of this. If you're looking to find something here that's useful for the typical user, then you want to go and narrow down what you're seeing here, narrow down what's in this list. And you could do that by going to the View menu. And in View, you can specify, instead of, say, all processes, you can do, say, just my processes. And you can see the user here changed to all Mac most on the right. It's because there's system processes that are being used, and there may be other users on your Mac too that aren't logged out. So this narrows it down a bit. But still a lot of stuff that are just background processes and things you don't need to worry about. So you could go further into active processes. And here's things that are actually running, actually doing things right now. So this is a much smaller list. But typically, if you go to window processes, you'll see exactly which apps are you're using, which ones have windows in your screen now. So that could be a very useful view as well. But let's leave it at active processes and try to take a look and see what we can get from this information. So you can see I've got tabs here at the top, and I can look at activity based on CPU, memory use, energy use, disk use, or network use. And I can sort by clicking on one of these columns here. So I can sort by CPU. Let me click on it again to sort the opposite way. So I can see what app is using the most CPU time. And it's my screen recorder. I'm recording this for the tutorial right now, and you can imagine that's using most of the CPU. Now, high number there doesn't necessarily mean that much because it's a percentage. So it's going to add up to 100%. But so 60% now may still only be using a fraction of my CPU. I can look at other things like memory. Go into there and sort by memory and see which tasks are using the most memory. I can see which ones are using the most energy. Reads and writes to the disk. And network access. So it's a good idea, a good way to get an idea of what your Mac is doing. But again, unless you're a software engineer, there's really not too much useful information you can get here. You may run into a situation where your Mac is running sluggishly or something, and maybe you can view your active processes here and try to figure out what's running. But if you don't recognize something like a kernel task or VDC assistant or launch D, then chances are that's not going to help you very much. However, if there's some sort of app you installed, like maybe you installed some sort of cleaner app or antivirus, things I don't recommend doing, but you may find if your Mac's running slow and then you see the name of that app there and it's using most of the CPU, then it gives you some sort of clue possibly as to what could be causing your Mac to slow down. Now there's kind of a danger here. It's that I see a lot of typical Mac users who aren't software engineers discovering Activity Monitor and then looking at these processes and getting obsessed with what each one does. Why is this one always there? Why is it running? Why can't I find any information when I search online about it? Things like that. And you know, in almost all cases when people try to investigate these things and they don't know what a process is, it turns out to be nothing. It turns out to be part of some app they've installed or part of the system or something like that. So I don't think Activity Monitor is particularly useful for typical Mac users. But it's good to know it's there, and if you are a little tech savvy, you might use it to maybe troubleshoot some problems.